11 Wizard. We'll take off and rendezvous with Texas over to the waypoint 2 and 3. Then follow the tanker on the flight to Piano. The rest of the crew and equipment will follow in two Globe Masters in around 1 hour. Thank you all for all of your efforts here. We'll see you in Italy, gentlemen. Wizard out.
Thank you, ma'am. It was always nice to hear you before you mentioned we flew here. See you in Aviano. Guys, I have to ask, did any of you imagine this was going to turn into a combat deployment when you got sent here?
Definitely not. Still can't really believe what happened. A handful of pilots with four aircraft against the whole Russian Air Force.
Yeah, hard to believe, isn't it? We couldn't win the war, but at least we helped to save some lives. Yeah. Have any of you seen any statistics on the casualties? I have, though I'm not sure they're reliable. Russian sources are claiming about 67 soldiers on their side were killed or wounded, plus around 60 South Ossetians. Should probably add a few pilots to that, I guess. Yeah, safe to say we've seen more than a couple of shoots. What about the Georgians? Between 150 and 170 soldiers dead, a few missing, over 1,000 wounded. Well, that's a lot. What about the civilians? More than 160 civilian casualties in South Ossetia, over 220 in Georgia from the reports I've seen. You have a very good memory for numbers, man. That's quite a lot of casualties for, what, 4 days of fighting? Yeah, it was definitely ugly down there.
Hey, the visit by the president yesterday was a nice touch. And his English is impeccable.
Seemed like a nice guy. If I'm not mistaken, he studied in the States. It was a kind gesture. I'm sure he has a lot on his head now after losing a war.
The Georgians never did stand a chance. I'm still amazed they got themselves dragged into it.
And you would just sit and wait while your people are shelled by artillery? Come on, guys. The truth is we don't really know who started it, but there'll be scores of politicians and historians who'll be throwing accusations at Saakashvili, the Russians, the separatists, hell, probably even the Martians. Bottom line is, Mexico, this is Dutch 1 plane approaching the rendezvous point. Dodge 1 Texaco, we have your vision. Continue with retreat. Texaco, Dodge 1-1, settle 3, rolling. Dodge Texaco, roger. Pick it up a little bit. Look up at 360, indicated airspeed. Dodge 1, copy, 360 indicated.
Two, wheel move. Four, rolling.
So I guess the big question is, what will happen next? Do you think that the Russians will stick to their ceasefire plan and withdraw their forces?
From Georgia, yes. From South Ossetia and Abkhazia, I wouldn't be so sure. Though the French, who led the negotiations, seem to be pretty determined to see that all 6 points are fulfilled. I wonder what they'll do if Russia doesn't comply. Probably either us or somebody else will have to return here and make sure that they do. Perhaps the French will send some of their barrages and fall. Without formal NATO backing? I doubt it. I don't know, as a warning? Why not? I'm sure that the Russian Air Force never saw us coming. They'll think twice now before doing anything. At least they should. You know what is the craziest thing? News media. There were so many articles about what was happening. Some were claiming, quite to the point, I dare say, that American jets were helping the Georgians. Others just took us for Russian flankers. But even the Kremlin didn't make it public, even though they did attack our government for supporting Saakashvili. I think that even if they did release some evidence of what we were doing, it wouldn't help with PR. If the world saw the U.S. involved militarily against Russia for the first time since the end of the Cold War, that would probably garner more sympathy for the Georgians than for Moscow.
Yeah, plus, remember that we're having the Olympics in Beijing right now. Everyone's attention is there. I think that's one of the reasons for the less media coverage than what we might normally see.
Yeah, I guess that all makes sense. If you had the usual fog of war on top of that, it's not really a surprise after all. Well, we should let the French handle this from now on. It's been a long few days. I know I, for one, am looking forward to landing in Aviano, finally getting a good night's sleep.
Now you're talking. How long will it take until we get there?
Probably gonna be a little while. Let me check with Texaco. Rick, Texaco.11, what is our ETA for Aviano?
Dodge 11, Texaco. We should arrive in around 5 hours.
Roger, Texaco, thank you. All right, gentlemen, get comfy and let's enjoy this beautiful sunrise over the Black Sea. Thank you for all you've done here. Dodge 11 out.
Dodge 11, this is Wizard. We are witnessing serious escalation of the South Ossetian conflict.
I've heard the news that the situation at the line of contact is getting really tense.
Cold 02, this is Magic. We have you visual.
Dodge 11, Magic. Situation on the ground is changing fast and we face looks like a full-scale war.
Grodinski Commanding Center Alpha, receive command from 22.
Dodge 3, Buffalo, you and Lima Charlie.
Dodge 4, Alpha, we had contact with 12 bombing. Here it goes.
Good, honey.
Shit.
I don't really like going after helos.
Dodge 4-1, Rock 4, pop up code, 033 for 85, Angel 10, flanking.
Roger that. I'll stay in comms in case you need any moral support.
Dodge 4-1, Seagull 1, copy. The ambassador would like to pass his regards. Wait, 1.
Gentlemen, this is Ambassador John Tassi. You've done an outstanding job today.
Thank you, sir. Just wanted to say that we all appreciate what